Taking a picture of you, that's what I'm doing.
Who last marched in South Carolina for Jackson.
package.
The named champions of the United States drill team from our own St. Peter's College. The Pershing Rifles, ladies and gentlemen. You salute us, we salute you. Pershing Rifles, you're marching as proud as peacocks. Thank you very much. Thank you. They said they were proud to march in this, the 34th annual parade. Thank you, Pershing Rifles. This is an indication of the young people who one day will be the leaders of the future. The Pershing Rifles, national champions. As of March 1984, when they won a competition at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. Ladies and gentlemen, marching for the first time in the Columbus Day Parade, we have the old city, Jersey City High School Band, under the leadership of Edith Phillips, supervisor Cliff Reiner, and Joe Pechillo. 150 strong, all students at the Jersey City Public High School who have banded together to form the Jersey City
City. Father,
Paul Pechillo. I will you march out now. Thank you. And ladies and gentlemen, immediately behind this group, if you will, we have the distinguished representative from the 14th Congressional District, the Honorable Congressman Frank J. Garrini. Marching with Congressman Garrini is the hardworking, dynamic chairperson of this year's parade, Friend Samaro. And then we have the dynamic chief executive of the city of Jersey City, Mayor Jerry McCann. And to those of you who remember this Rhodes Scholar who cavorted on the basketball court but is now making an enviable reputation in the halls of the Senate, let's say hello to Senator Bill Bradley. Thank you. Let's hear it for these distinguished individuals who took time out from their busy schedules to pay tribute to Christopher Columbus. This parade, we have Vinnie Signorelle, Frank Pechillo, Joe Colasso, the perennial treasurer, Viola Disbro, recording secretary, Gloria Benacolta, Stella Scuzzese, Dan Beck, Gene Smaro, Josephine Marquito, the executive director of the Parking Authority, John Vicari, Anthony Fiola, who was the chairman of our dinner, who restored dignity to the Columbus Committee, and that was a class job you did, Anthony. Dan Beck. Let me tell you something. Remember what I told you about the parade order? May I ask you, where is the music? This is the governing body of the city of Jersey City. You can get in there, Joan Quigley. I recognize you. Councilwoman Mary Abigliano. Council President Bobby Jackson. Councilman Thomas Frischone, carrying his adopted daughter. Councilman Glenn Cunningham. Councilman Harold Zelaznicki. Councilman Robert Betts. Bill O'Day. Joan Quigley, Linda Frischone, all people instrumental in the day-by-day operation of our city government. Councilman Abigliano, you did a wonderful job on the dinner. Nick LaRocca, Assemblyman Nick LaRocca, the freeholder from my district, Ann O'Malley, Senator Ed O'Connor, Assemblyman Joe Charles, Elnardo Webster, whom I saw score 51 points at Madison Square Garden, Marilyn Roman, Nydia Cologne, Don DeLeo, and I don't know, that's not bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 out of 10 is not a bad percentage. Assemblyman Anthony Veneri, 9 out of 10. All right. And here, ladies and gentlemen, from Frank Rogers Town, Harrison, New Jersey, these are the Harrison High School cheerleaders. You've read about them. They are currently the 1984 World Champion cheerleaders. Ladies and gentlemen, I promised Mayor Rogers that if these champion cheerleaders participated in the parade, that we would permit them to do a routine that earned them the world championship. To the song, Holding Out for a Hero, the Harrison High School cheerleaders. and gentlemen. Just a minute. Who's your choreographer? What's your name?
Right here.
Bob Trembley. We salute you. There's no question in our minds that you are truly the world's champions, and we now national champions, but next year you'll win the world championship. We salute you. We salute Mr. Gregory, and we salute Mr. Trembley. God love you. You are sensational. Believe me. And Harrison should be proud of you. See, I'm improvising, working without a script. Please forgive me. We salute you. Okay, next year you'll be world champion again. From the Peninsula City in Bayonne, ladies and gentlemen, the chief executive, the mayor of Bayonne, the Honorable Dennis Collins, Councilman Neil DeSena, Jack Foy, Council President. Ladies and gentlemen, you just saw Columbus Day Parade, the world-renowned Skyliners from New York. These are the Skyliners, ladies and gentlemen. Ray Richardson, commanding, musical director.
Columbus, but he answers to the name of Frank
pass in review on the Statue of Liberty. On the Statue of Liberty floats a young lady who 5 years ago was designated and won the contest as Miss Columbus. This year, 5 years later, she went and she competed in the Miss America contest. This is Miss New Jersey of 1984, Patricia Charlene LaPera. And I want to tell you something. 5 years ago, when she was selected as Miss Columbus, I was the chairman of the panel that picked her as Miss Columbus. So with pardonable pride, I say, 5 years ago, I had an eye for beauty. I still have the eye. Congressman Guarini said, what happened? Mayor McCann said, yeah, Ed, tell us what happened. I still have an eye for beauty. Isn't she beautiful? Mr. Penna designed that Statue of Liberty. Charlene, Patricia Charlene LaPera. And to those of you who don't know it, she's from West New York, New Jersey. Let's hear it for Miss New Jersey. Peter Penna, this distinguished man, made this out of copper. Peter Penna. Well, Pete, the Statue of Liberty will never be the same because you've got Patricia, Miss New Jersey, riding with it. Department of Public Works I'm going to ask her if she will to stand and take a bow. The Italian Woman of the Year, a member of the bar, practicing attorney, the first female president of the Hudson County Bar Association, Anne Marie B. Paterno. Mrs. Pagano, Anna Pagano, Mrs. Oscar Cavello, who's a youngster by Marie Gemino standards. Mrs. Isabel Cavello is only 87 years old. So she's a kid compared to Maria Gemino, who's 92. In the second car, Marion Papagna, Lena Calabrese, Ann Maluso, Josephine Ferrara. This is the Disabled American Veterans Fort Monmouth Chapter 29.
What is this?
This is Carol Hayes. If you go up north on the boulevard, you'll see the Carol Hayes Dance Studio. They celebrate Columbus Day, and unless I miss my guess, we're going to be treated to a recital and to a dance by Carol Hayes students. These are the ballerinas, the dance team from Carol Hayes on the boulevard. This is an Italian folk dance. Viva l'America e viva l'Italia. Questa è la tarantella. Which in French means hello.
Thank you.
see you have them all ages, all sizes, all shapes. Are these all your pupils? You need a partner, honey? By the younger members of the Carol Hayes studio. And I see some young men there. Are they going to be Fred Astaire's or Michael Jackson's or what? Well, show me Michael Jackson. Show me your stuff, pal. Okay, guys, you look great. You look great, really, you do. I like the mothers that are escorting you. They look great too.
I know.
Yeah, I know. All right, ladies and gentlemen, these are the students from the Carol Hayes Dance Studio, located on the boulevard, north of Journal Square, on the right-hand side. Here comes Izzy Michell and the local 526 Musician Union Band. Can you imagine Izzy Michell, a lanceman, playing Way Marie?
Columbus of 1984
a junior at St. Aloysius Academy, Constance DeVito. Constance DeVito. The first runner-up, Gina D'Amico. Gina D'Amico. The second runner-up, Renee Maggio. Six beautiful Americans of Italian extraction. We of the committee salute you. You are indeed truly beautiful. Affectionately known as Mr. Veteran, civic leader, been associated with the veterans groups for many, many years. Jim Calabrese was also here with me 34 years ago. Jim, good luck. May you be here a long time to come. God keep you well. And now, the state commander. And with Vic Tamaro is a Jersey City nurse, ladies and gentlemen, who participated in the D-Day invasion during World War II. This is Victor Sparrow. He's still a gentleman. With your strength, Vicky, you're going to pull the door off. The lady that's about to exit the car, if Victor Smarrow ever can get the door open, let her come out the other way. Climb over the seat. This woman, believe it or not, you know why I asked her to climb over the seat? She was the first American nurse to land on Omaha Beach during the Normandy Day invasion, and she's from Jersey City. You see the medals she's wearing? This is our own Anna Ritchie. World War II lieutenant, a nurse in the United States Army, and was the first American nurse to land on Omaha Beach. Jersey City's own. We're proud of you. And Victor, why don't you get a new car or a car where the doors open? I'm going to ask the mayor and the congressman to see what they can do about talking to the Department of New Jersey AmBets. You deserve a better car than that. Mayor, you think you can do it, please? Provincia di Campo Basso, il paese si chiama Capri Nostro. You know I'm kidding. You know. And don't ask the question that you always do whenever we get a pipe band and they're wearing kilts. I don't know the answer. Oh, they've been here before. Wait a while. I got to look at the drum. The Tri-County Pipe Band. Great music. The bagpipes astounding, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Tri-County Pipe Band from Bergen County. From downtown Jersey City, the Paula Crooks Association, Joe Duffy, ladies and gentlemen, Joe Duffy. This is the historic Paula Crooks Association from downtown Jersey City, Joe Duffy, who keeps year after year keeping alive the tradition of the Paula's Hook Battle that was fought in downtown Jersey City during the Revolutionary War. A district, the Paula's Hook, rich in history. And Joe Duffy is keeping that tradition alive. These are the four hello to the Paulus Hook Patriots. Hello, Paulus Hook Patriots. Hello. And goodbye now to Joe Duffy and the Paulus Hook Association and the Patriots, and thank you. This is the General Pulaski Memorial Committee. Paul Kaprowski, Marshal, Stan Rotapel, President, my dear friend Eddie Balthazak, Vice President, Joseph Kasich, Vice President, Eleanor Torek, Vice President, Joseph Baddock, Secretary, Mo Presti, Sergeant at Arms, Charlie Boss, the Coordinator, and that illustrious editor of New Jersey's leading Polish-American newspaper, the Post Eagle, my very dear friend, Chester Grabowski. And next to him is Eddie Balthazak. Ladies in the native dress, ladies and gentlemen, Alice Litke, Dorothy Balthazak, Donna Rotopel, and Bernice Machno. I don't know the names of the flag bearers, but you should be proud. First, that you're carrying the American flag, and secondly, that you're carrying the flag representing the Republic of Poland. Fearless communist fighters. God bless you all. All right, ladies and gentlemen. You saw some Americans of Italian extraction that were beauties. Now, let us salute the Polish belles. Miss Polonia of Jersey City, Marianne Jablonski. Marianne. Somebody said you look Italian, Marianne. Miss, her attendant, the court of Miss Polonia, Miss Marie Kulikowski, Kimberly Bushka, Debbie Bushka. Now all four of you stand up and let's have a generous round of applause for these beautiful Polish young beauties. God love you. You can leave your names and telephone numbers. Aide to Mayor Steve Capriello from the Miles Square City, ladies and gentlemen, Maurice Fitzgibbon.
Yeah, we're in the office belt if you all want to drink coffee or something. Tom, how are you doing?
Girls strut.
cheerleaders. This is the Hoboken Marching Band. The director is Gary Enrico. Gary Enrico.
About to
election review, ladies and gentlemen. 1983-84, American Legion Parade champion, the Melrose Blackhawk Senior Drummond Bugle Corps. No wonder you're champion. You sound great. Jim Kilcommons is the director. We salute the Melrose Blackhawk Senior Drummer Bugle Corps, American Legion champions for the past 2 years.
Thank you.
Look at the Grand Marshal is even moving out there. And show the Irish Galano. Great acrobats. Yeah! fund of Local 325, I'm advised by Mayor McCann, help build that beautiful office building right here to my right. A great union, a great... This band about to pass in review. You know, I don't know about you, but don't you get a kick out of drum major and how they strut when they lead their contingent? Look at how beautiful this man looks leading this pipe band. This is still part of Local 325. Columbus. This is the Bayonne Cadet.
name is Newby. I recognize you. Beautiful children. This is the A. Philip Randolph Institute. Ruby Jones, president. Thank you for participating in Walter Cheek. Thank you for participating and joining with us in this Ruby that I enjoy watching every year. From the Greenville section of Jersey City, under the direction of Dwayne Bradley, we have the Soul Steppers. Are you going to move for the judge today? Are you going to dance for the judge today and for Mayor McCann and for Congressman Garini and for Senator Bill Bradley and for Assemblyman LaRocco and for Harold Delacetsky and for Glenn Cunningham and for Mary of Egliano and for Bob Bent and for all of us? For Tom Frischone, are you going to move for us? Move! I enjoy this delightful group of young section of Jersey City, the soul step. And once again, the local 14 of the Plumbers Local. The district comprised Jersey City, Bayonne, and Hoboken. This is a grading machine, equipment from local 825.
thing do, sir, to grade the road.
John Deere,
Union Made International Ladies Garment Workers Union, AFL-CIO. Remember years ago they had the commercial, make sure, look for the union label, that's it. Look for the union label. I see somebody is off today. There's no one operating that machine. They get double time if they work today. God bless the union. Listen, don't worry. I was just made an honorary member of Local 325.